What's going on, guys? PC here, and welcome to another episode of First Look. Today we're taking a first look at skateboarding, or MTV skateboarding, featuring Andy McDonald. It is a skateboarding game by MTV, as you might imagine from the title. It's definitely not going to be a Tony Hawk killer, I'm sure of it, even though I've never played the game. I've had this game in my collection for a long time. I just haven't gotten around to playing it, mainly because, yeah, it's not going to be a Tony Hawk killer. And second, it does not support VGA, which is a negative right off the bat. It's amazing. Going from VGA to composite again, man, it's like you all of a sudden need glasses. Everything's blurry. But I guess I'll have to deal with it. But anyway, I'm going to get so many copyright claims from this video as well. As you might imagine, since it is an MTV game, it's going to have licensed music in it. I mean, so does Tony Hawk, but... But yeah, oh well. Anyway, let's jump into a single-player campaign here. Not really campaign, but whatever. Single-player game. Free play, lifestyle, high score, MTV hunt, survival, stunt mode. Quite a few modes. I have no idea what half of these would actually be. Lifestyle, MTV hunt, survival mode. I mean, stunt mode, free play, high score, pretty self-explanatory. The other ones I'm not sure. But decent variety of modes, which is cool. Let's go into free play, though. Get used to the actual game and the controls and whatnot. Weird that there's no music in the actual menu. There's music at the title screen, and then when you go into the menu, it's just silent. It's kind of odd. Anyway, let's pick a skater. So I'm guessing Tony Hawk is not going to be in this. We have Rob Drydeck? Heidi Fitzgerald, Brian Howard, Rick Howard, Keith Hoffnagel. I'm going to butcher so many of these names. Scott Johnston, Josh Collis, Andy McDonald, the title character, and back to Colin McKay. Actually, no, we didn't go back to Colin McKay yet. So, Jen O'Brien, Alan Peterson, Danny Way, quite a few skaters in this. Stevie Williams, Salvador Barbier, and Rob Drydeck was the first one. Or Dyer Deck. Weird that he's actually the first skater that you see by default. You would think McDonald would be the first one, since he is the title of the game, but oh well. We'll go with the first one, just for the heck of it. Maybe he's the easiest or kind of the mid-range skater, and that's why they put him first. I don't know. Alright, we're going to Murphy's Playhouse. Alright, we are skating. I did a 360 flip. My strategy with Tony Hawk is usually just to press a whole bunch of random buttons and hope I do something cool. That's pretty much going to be my strategy here as well, so... I think I've got those 360 flips down. Okay, this does support the analog stick as well as the D-pad. Man, he's glitching out there. I'm just going to do 360 flips. Seems to be about all I can pull off. Ooh, I did a K-grind there. I don't know what the grind button is. Let's see if I can find a rail somewhere around here. There we go. If I can actually get up to it. I didn't mean to do that. A button is jump. That's the same as Tony Hawk, I believe. I can grind the top of this. Ouch. I don't know if I pressed the right button there. I died. I do know how to do a few tricks in Tony Hawk. They don't seem to be working here. I don't know if this actually uses the same buttons. Man, I am wiping out like crazy. Where is this audience that's booing at me anyway? I don't see anyone around. I'm pretty sure I'm in an empty warehouse here. Man, I don't know how to do anything. Well, I did a nosebone. Pretty decent points out of that. How do I grind? That's really what I want to know. Alright, I can try on this rail over here if I can actually get over there. Gonna crash one more time. Be the last time, I'm sure of it. Okay, Y is grind. Okay. I think that's the same as Tony Hawk, the Y button. Let's see if I can do some... Okay, yeah. I'm trying to do a nose grind. Oh. Okay, grind. Alright, so grinding's pretty much the same. It has the balance meter like Tony Hawk, so... Yeah, it's all the same. I was trying to do that, trick you do at the top of a ramp in Tony Hawk. Press forward and grind. Forward and the Y button. You usually do the handstand thing. I forget what it's called. I'm not a skateboarder, so I don't know the terms. I mean, so far this seems alright. I mean, it's not bad. It doesn't feel quite as nice as Tony Hawk. I don't know why I keep doing that. I keep trying to do that one trick that I was trying to do. And it doesn't work, and I'm not learning my lesson, so... Yeah, it doesn't feel quite as nice control-wise as Tony Hawk. Not quite as fluid and natural. It feels a bit more stiff. But it controls alright. It's not bad. It's not a complete disaster. Well, that was nice. Four tricks in one. Sweet. So there's no time limit in this. This is just a free run, I guess. Alright, now that I kind of figured out the controls a bit, let's go into one of the other modes just to see. Just to see what they're like. I kind of want to try that MTV Hunt one. Curious what that is. Alright, gotta enter a name for this one. If you collect 10 MTV logos, they'll give you a free pass to the next skate park. If you can also collect all 5 board sections, one of the park sponsors will give you a free board. Go for it. Okay, sounds good. So they're copying a lot of things from Tony Hawk. Like collecting logos and boards and things like that. If I can grab one of these logos. There we go. Bit of a guitar riff when you grab one. Ow. I love how he just turns into a stiff board. Just completely passes out when he wipes out. Oh, okay, so it's not actually giving me any points for tricks in this game mode. So I guess the entire objective of this is just to collect logos. I don't know why they would have made this into a mode by itself. Because if I remember right, Tony Hawk had these bonus objectives in the main mode. So you can collect the logos and various hidden items like the tapes and whatnot. But in the regular campaign mode, not as a separate mode. I don't know how to get out of this bowl. Oh, did I actually lose a logo? I think I did. Oh. So if you wipe out, you actually lose the logos that you've collected. That actually makes things a lot more challenging. I still don't know how to get out of this.
People see Rockstar, you know what I'm saying? But you're still...
How do I get out of here? See, normally in Tony Hawk, you just push forward on the D-pad or the analog stick, and you can get out of a bowl or whatever this is called. It's not working here, though. How to exit. Alright, well, I get the idea of this mode anyway. Yeah, you collect stuff, and you do nothing else, pretty much. Not really the greatest idea for a game mode, I don't think. It's just, like, adding bonus objectives. And instead of adding bonus objectives to the main mode, they're just making it into its own mode. Kind of odd, but, what's lifestyle? Is that an actual mode? I guess it is. Let's go with the Billy J. Jim Bob. That is not an actual skater, is it? Yeah, I think these are custom skaters. So you can, I guess, up their skills by doing stuff. With outfit 3, whatever. Yeah, this is a... seems to be a... custom skater mode. You've been invited to join a local competition at Murphy's Playhouse. If you can achieve a score of 6.0 or higher, you'll be on the first step to the ladder of the ladder to skateboarding fame. Sounds good to me. So this is sort of a campaign mode where you take an amateur skater from amateur to pro, I guess? I guess that makes sense. Alright, so I need to get a decent score here. See if we can do it. Oh, I didn't mean to grind. This is high score is 200,000. I hope I don't have to get 200,000. I keep doing grinds accidentally. Really need to avoid pressing the Y button at the top of a ramp. Not bad, not bad. Alright, I'm gonna grind a bit. Not like that. I wonder if I can wall grind in this. Doesn't look like it. Try that again. No. At least I can't wall grind in the same way that you can in Tony Hawk, anyway. Grind up here. Yeah, that was bad. That was bad. Got 15 seconds left. Let me try and get a couple more tricks in. See if we have enough. Not bad. I'm gonna wipe out. What a way to end. Failed. Alright, what did I need for a score? So I got, best trick combo, 9,142, front side, nose bone, plus Leon method. Judge 1, 5.5, 6.1, 5.0, 5.0, 5.3, you should try staying on the skateboard. Thanks for the tip. Keep on trying different tricks. Try holding the grabs for longer and rotate. Alright, we'll try it one more time. I don't know what I need, as far as the score goes. I think it actually said in the instructions at the beginning, but I forgot what it was. Just gonna keep going back and forth. See, I don't know if they're scoring me on my total score are rating me on my total score. It might just be the tricks that I do and the variety of tricks. Not entirely, sir. Not entirely, sir. Not entirely sure. Ooh, that was an awesome trick. I have no chance at this, do I? At least in Tony Hawk, I know how to do some things. I mean, for the most part, I do button mash. But I do know how to do a few things, like grinds. Grinds. And, that thing at the top of the ramp that I can't think of the name of, where you do kind of a handstand thing. You can do that. And of course, 360s. You know, who can't do a 360? I'm doing much worse than I did on the first round. Much worse. Oh, I can do a transfer. Actually, if I can do a trick plus a transfer, that would be pretty sweet. I'm not even gonna land my trick. I wasn't sure if I was gonna get up there, that I was gonna get stuck in that wall. That couldn't have gone much worse. 1.1 from all of the judges. Apparently that is the lowest score you can get. Unless you can get a 1.0, but... that's a pity extra 0.1 points. Yeah, that was terrible. Absolutely terrible. Alright, well, I'm not going to play any more of this. I think you guys get the basic idea. It's okay. You know, it's a competent skateboarding game. It's not going to unseat Tony Hawk is the king of the skateboarding games. So, and it doesn't support VGA, so it doesn't look all that great. And the graphics aren't that great in the first place. So, graphics department, not so great. Music, I guess, is good if you like the sort of music that's in the game. It's licensed music. I have not heard any of this music. It's not really my genre, so. But, of course, the music in Tony Hawk is not my genre either, but I love it because it goes great with the game. And it's nostalgic because I played Tony Hawk a lot as a kid, so. But yeah, as far as this game goes, it's a decent skateboarding game. If you want something different and you've played the heck out of Tony Hawk 1 and 2 on the Dreamcast, then I guess you can give it a shot. But it's alright. Anyway, guys, that is it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. And thanks for watching.